Hello everyone, so today we're gonna make, what are we gonna make? Oh yeah, a gluten-free Christmas log, so like a bûche de Noël. So it's a little to my friend Fran Lawton, which asked for me to do a bûche de Noël. So this one is gonna be even better, it's gluten-free. So we're gonna start to do a chocolate ganache, dark chocolate ganache. So I've got 425 grams of dark chocolate. So those are buttons, but you can shop the big tablet. And we're gonna put 500 grams of whipping cream to boil. And once it's boiling, we're gonna pour it onto our chocolate. Okay. So that's easy so far. There we go. Then we're gonna make our sponge. So we're gonna use this one to do a meringue. And by hand, we're gonna whisk the egg yolk and sugar together. Sorry, I was not ready actually. I need a whisk. Everything fall over. Okay, so what do we got here? We're gonna start with our yolk. So we got 200 grams of yolks. 200 grams. And we're gonna whip it with 100 grams of caster sugar. So we're gonna whisk it. As much as we can, yeah? Until it goes white pale. So I've done it until a very light consistency. Yeah. Whew, that was tiring. Okay, so now what do we need?
We need a bowl.
So here we're gonna put 300 grams of egg white into a very clean bowl. Huh? If we do, because we're gonna whip a meringue, so you have to make sure that your bowl is grease, you know, greaseless and very clean. Yeah, otherwise we'll never whip. So this time we're gonna use the KitchenAid. Okay, and we're just gonna whip this with the sugar, which is 210 grams sugar. Okay, so when it starts to go a bit foamy like that, you can put a little bit of sugar. Wait. And a little bit more. So it's gonna create a very firm meringue. I could have done that by hand easily. And the rest of your sugar. And now you let it firm it, yeah? So this is very firm, okay? We say a good meringue, you can tip it over. And it's all good, yeah? So this is gonna go into the egg yolk. Okay, we're just gonna fold that two together gently so we don't lose any air. Okay, Then we're gonna sieve 90 grams of pure cocoa powder. Which you have to sieve already. And this, you just tip it over in there. So this is moving, hold on. Got it? Thank you. So you're doing some round movement with your whisk, yeah? Don't go too crazy, keep it very gentle. Kind of like you'd be doing a chocolate mousse, same. There we go. This kind of consistency you need to have. It holds itself, yeah? So you can pipe it easily. Okay, so let's pipe it on a tray. Up, I'm gonna take a flat nozzle. So we have a very thin sponge. Okay. So I'm gonna start to pipe the frame. So this tray is 60 centimeters by 40 centimeters. Okay, so we've made one tray and a half with this recipe. So basically it's like three trays from your domestic oven. Okay, the cream is boiling now, so we're gonna pour it into our chocolate. And we're gonna melt all those little chocolate buttons until a nice and smooth consistency. In a minute, we're gonna bake those, yeah? But we have to do that. So once it's all mixed, we're gonna let it cool down as quick as possible so we can use it to do our Christmas log. Voilà. So this is all nice, smooth, no more pieces of chocolate. Beautiful. You can add a little nut of butter if you want at this stage to give a bit of shine. I'll leave it like that, me. So this one, we're gonna bake it at 170 for I don't know how long. Probably 10 minutes, but we're gonna check and we'll let you know. Okay, one here. And one there. Put those, yeah, so the paper won't fly away. Thank you. 10 minutos. Okay, so that's been 5 minutes. Another probably 5 minutes. To be exact, I will tell you exactly how long. Okay, so we've put it in total 20 minutes and not 10. So this is done, yeah? So straight on a rack so it can cool down. There we go. There we go. So we're gonna let it cool down. It smells amazing. It's very fluffy and light. And once it's cooled down, we're gonna build it up with the ganache. See you in a bit. Okay, so those two are cold now. They've been cooled down. I'm not telling you what we've done during all that time. Okay, so we're just gonna use this little half. Gonna remove the paper, okay. Up. We're gonna reuse this same paper. And we're gonna make a little syrup. So, I got some boiling water coming. We're just gonna put 125 sugar. Top up with 250 boiling water. There. And 10% of rum. So we have a timer beeping. So it's gonna be 3:30. How much do we have? 37 gram of rum. So it can be gluten-free, but it's not alcohol-free. Okay, so the sugar is all melted, dissolved into this hot water. We have the rum. Because rum and chocolate is quite a good combination. I like it. You can do it without alcohol, of course. So we're gonna soak the sponge everywhere. Not too much as well, huh? Just enough. Don't forget the sides. You can touch it. It's nice. So that's enough. So obviously I have some left, which you can do a cocktail with it. So the ganache. The ganache has set. Okay. So we're gonna use it, it's pipeable. So we're gonna use it now. So let's pipe it. Again with a flat nozzle, so it's not too much. So I'm gonna start here. Leave this little gap, because when we're gonna fold it, it will cover. So this is a very traditional recipe for bûche de Noël in France. You can do it with a plain sponge and buttercream, which you can flavor with anything you like. Okay, that's enough. There's little gaps, but it's okay because it's gonna roll and spread everywhere. So the first, and then all the way. Squeeze it. Ta-da! So we have our roll here. And now what we do, I put it on this little thing. Just gonna cut the edge. I use it here on top of the log to make it realistic as a wood log. Let's take the whole baby onto the board card. So it's very soft, huh? Obviously. Okay, so now we're gonna finish it. So now we're gonna pipe the rest of the ganache. So we start from the base and we're gonna cover it all. Then, with a palette knife, we're just gonna spread it gently. A bit everywhere. So it has to look like a wood log, so we're gonna shape it, make the bark effect. Maybe with a little bit of that, kind of barky, Winnie. Something like that. We're gonna let it set in the fridge and come back to it in a minute. Okay, so he had like 20 minutes in the fridge, just to let it set, you know. So we can do even more details on it. So what we have left as ganache is not much. Just gonna put on the side here to smooth the sides. So it's totally covered there. Yeah? Okay. Little bit of cocoa powder. Much, quite light. There, let's put a little bit of snow. Why not? And I think that's it. There we go, so the bûche de Noël, chocolate roulade, whatever you want to call it. Special dédicace for Fran, our friend. And yeah, that's all really. So if you still like our video, if you love us, please comment on our Facebook page, at Julien Picamille. And I'm trying to answering you all the time. And please subscribe. Thank you. Bye.